This video is going to show you the difference of the power side of the amp and the speaker side of the amp. What we're going to do is measure the power. We're going to measure in voltage and amperage on each side and then calculate the wattage. I'm going to show you that the power side is DC. The speaker side is AC. I'm going to show you the difference between those two. This is a JL500/1 amplifier hooked up to a JL10W7. This amplifier is a 500 watt regulated amplifier. That means that at any resistance it is stable at, it will deliver 500 watts. It's stable at 1.5 ohms to 4 ohms. And most amps are unregulated amps, so they wouldn't be able to deliver max power at all resistance values it supports. A 500 watt unregulated amp would normally be 500 watts at 2 ohms and about 250 watts at 4 ohms. They can vary in values, but that's just a rough estimate to give you an idea. Have a couple of meters. This one's just a digital multimeter set on volts, DC, and it's coming over here to the DC side. This one's an oscilloscope set on AC. It's coming over here to the AC side of the speaker. It's also going to show us the waveform and frequency. This one's a DC, or well, it's set on DC amps and it's hooked up to the power wire from the power supply that's going to be delivering to the amp. This one's an AC amp meter. It's set on AC and it's going to measure the speaker amp wire amp value. So the speaker wire comes over here back to the amp, power wire comes out of here, goes into this computer power supply. That's being powered out the wall. So we got AC power, convert it to DC power, DC into the amp, AC out of the amp to the speaker. So first off, I need to show you what the difference is between AC and DC power so you can understand what's going on. I got another oscilloscope. This one has a larger display. It's easier to see. I'm going to show you DC power with the 18 volt drill battery. It's going to be on channel 1. This is my probe. Coming over here is channel 1. Then channel 2, come down here to another probe, is connected to some speaker wire to a separate amp I got in the background, and I'll show you AC voltage on there to give you understanding the difference between DC, which is direct current, and AC, alternating current, is to show you it visually what it looks like. So I'm gonna hook up the probe to the battery. And what we get is we see a rise. What this means is there's squares on this grid. Each square is a value in voltage, and currently each square is 10 volts. I can change that. Each volt can be 20. But 10 volts is a good one to show for 18. So at this value, each square is worth 10 volts. And when we connect the battery, we're just slightly under 2 squares. So if each square is worth 10, then that gives us our 18. And each square going across represents time, and that's at 5 milliseconds. So we can see that through time, left and right, DC volt doesn't change. It's always constant. That's why it's direct current. Turn on the voltmeter over here. And you can see there's our 18 volts. So those two squares will be 20, and then slightly under is our 18. And DC works. It has to be a certain polarity, positive to positive, negative to negative. If I reverse that polarity, then I get negative 18, and then instead of a rise, we get a fall. And the fall is constant over time, same as what the rise did. It's just reverse polarity, so the result is going to be reversed. So I'm going to show you what AC voltage looks like. And right now, I'm playing a 50 hertz track. So this represents 50 hertz, a 50 hertz waveform. And you can see alternating is constantly going up and down, up and down. That's why it's alternating. It's flipping. And that 50 hertz is pretty similar to what you would get out the wall. Out the wall is 60 hertz. So it's only 10 hertz difference. Except for out of the wall, it's going to be a lot greater waveform because it's going to be 120 volts. Right now, each of these squares are worth 0.5 volts. So this is a lot lower than what you would get out the wall. So to measure the frequency, and just adjust this, let me explain what it is. Is each waveform is a complete wave starts at a specific point. You have to go up and down. So right here I'm going down, and then I go up, and then when I'm in the downward motion again, that's one full complete wave. So you have to complete each motion to get a full waveform. Adjust that. So what I got is the center line gives me a good starting point. So I'm finding where it crosses the center line here. Then I'm going down. And then on my downward motion again, when it crosses the center line, these are my two points, and this is one full wave. And I'm measuring that at 50 hertz. This is what AC power looks like, and this is what speaker outputs would be. This is your frequency. This is a 50 hertz. If you were to play this through a speaker, you'd hear a 50 hertz tone. And what I'm gonna do is show you what happens when you increase the volume. So when you increase the volume, the voltage increases. The wave never changes, it's still 50 hertz. You just have more volume, which is in relation to voltage. So right now, about 3 3/4 of squares. There's a little bit of noise, so that's a little off. You can see the meter's picking up some noise from here, so it's calculating it a little bit off. So now I'm gonna play the same 50 hertz we're seeing over here through the sub and see what we can get. Got the volume. See, it's calculating 50 hertz. It just vibrated off. It's picking up the 50 hertz. 0.7 volts. This is on the speaker side. This is the AC. The DC from the power supply is 12. This is the amperage off the power side. DC 3.2. So 7.76. And 0.6 amps. So if we want to see that in wattage, take 7.76 times 0.6. And jumped up to 0.7, but staying steady mostly at 0.6, that's what we'll use. So that's only 4.6 watts. That's on the speaker side. On the power side, let's take 12.08 times 3.2. And that's 38 watts. It's a pretty big difference. Now, if I increase the gain, then I'm going to become louder. And the voltage amperage is going to increase over here. The speaker side, or the power side, is going to be the same voltage until it starts pull a drain over here, and the amperage is going to increase over here. So now we're at 12.04. So as it increases, it puts a load on it, and the voltage is going to drop on the DC side. But then the amperage is going to go up because it's requesting more power. So now we're on the power side, we're using 69 watts. And over here on the speaker side, . 18.3 times 1.9. it's over 34. So right now we're somewhere around 50% efficient, because it's taking almost double the power DC to produce the power at AC. Pretty much what I want to show you. As it increases, when you increase your gain and get closer to 500 watts, it'll be more efficient. But this is how you calculate your wattage. Speaker is AC power because it's a specific frequency. We got AC amps, AC volts, and then coming in is DC volts. It fell off again. And DC amps. One last thing. I'll show you what some music looks like. This is what music would look like. You have different frequencies changing over time.